his overall 538 average is going up. This is a guy who is, you know, he's sitting at 50% in some polls, and other polls keep moving up. This isn't a guy that's going to say, oh, hey, yeah, I'm getting more popular. I think now's a great time to just quit after 2022, after Kyiv, after making history. I mean, this guy's going.
Yeah, and I, you know, I was texting with Kate Benningfield over the weekend, who is the outgoing White House communications director. This is her last week, and just congratulating her, you know, Ron Klain, the team that had been in place for the last 2 years. They have, and the president has done absolutely everything to prove to the American people that he is more than capable of doing the job. And, you know, I think that is why we're in February, you know, but that is why the Republican primary is starting this week and the Democratic primary is not. The age question, it's always, that is always going to be there. Every administration has its crucible. That is his. That will always be there. But in terms of what more could he have done to prove his, have a proof of concept that his presidency is working, that the theory is working. You know, economy still has a long way to go, but things are improving. What he's done on the world stage, what he's sort of born physically, he can do this. And I think that is why you see no one suggesting that they would run. And I know there's been, you know, and likewise, I saw that there was some reporting and questioning whether the vice president will continue to be on the ticket. There is zero chance, let me tell you people, there is zero chance that Kamala Harris will not be on this, she will not be his running mate. There is no way they are taking her off the ticket. Everything that she has brought to the administration, the support she has within the base, like this is the, you know, for now, unless something dramatically different happens, Democrats start to step up to run. And I just don't see a scenario where that happens. Like, this is the ticket.
Yeah, and to Jen's point, Willie, not only what more does he need to do, what more do we need to know? President Biden stands by his decisions. We've seen that every step of the way. He's put a lot of points on the board, but even decisions like Afghanistan, he stood by. He has resolve on what he's doing. What more does he need to do? And what more do we need to know when Dr. Jill Biden says, yep, he's ready to go?
Well, yeah, that's the question. But I guess, John, it doesn't really matter at this point, right? I mean, when he announces a sort of a, it's a formality that doesn't quite affect the race all that much because nobody else really is threatening to get back in. So do we have a sense of his timetable where he may officially say, yeah, I'm going to make another run at it?
Yeah, they're not too worried about the Marianne Williamson bid. She's expected to announce her candidacy this week.
You are so on.
To challenge the president. Yeah, we saw, I think, from the First Lady this week, a little bit of growing frustration within the West Wing about these very questions as to whether he's going to run and when. Now, to be fair, the timeline has slipped some. They had been telegraphing. They thought they had announced soon after the State of the Union in February. That's, of course, no longer the case. They're now coalescing around April. That in part for fundraising purposes. You let that first quarter come and go, then you announce, and then you start raising money as opposed to having to report an incomplete quarter. They also point out that in 2011, April was when Barack Obama announced his reelection bid. Of course, there were no questions as to whether or not Obama was going to run for a second term. There have been for Biden, but the White House believes they have largely, they point to the resume and say, we've put those questions to rest. They point to his legislative record. They point to the contrast with the 4 years of Trump, emerging out of the pandemic, the aftermath of January 6th, and of course, as was so vividly on display last week, his leadership in the war in Europe and supporting Ukraine against Russia's invasions. And they feel like that they are, think they're well positioned, and they like the contrast they have, Joe, with the Republicans. And to yeah. Jen's point, the vice president is going to be on the ticket for many reasons, including, of course, that as noted, the base is the foundation of the Democratic Party right now, black women. They're not going to alienate that by pushing Vice President Harris off as Joe Biden's running mate.
Right. And you know, Biden, again, he's continuing to, it's slow and steady as far as his ratings go. Alex said, I accidentally said 50%. It's 44%. He's gone from the 30s to the low 40s. He's moving up. His average is moving up. He's now moving into the mid 40s. And I thought it was so interesting yesterday, Mark McKinnon, when we played the Jill Biden clip. She didn't say hope and change. She didn't play a rock star. Didn't say Joe Biden was going to be a rock star. You know, like, you know, Donald Trump tried to play this big, bigger than life, strong rock star. She basically said what our parents always said that may sound boring in the age of TikTok, but she was basically saying slow and steady gets the job done. He's steady. Americans needed somebody steady, somebody with resolve, somebody with a foundation, somebody that was going to stay there and hold this country together. And I thought, what a great message given the chaos that we've seen over the past 6-7 years and just how exhausted American voters are by what they have seen every day in the age of Trump. Hey, I'll take steady any day of the week. You know, people make fun of the new prime minister in Britain suggesting that he's not up to the task. You talk to people in Britain, they say the same thing.
Well,
he's
that's
steady.
Right. That's right, Joe.
He's steady.
And that's how he won in 2020. And a normal beats crazy as well. And if the Republican Party goes off the rails like it appears to be headed in that Republican primary, given all the MAGA physics, then I think Joe Biden's had a chance. But the one thing that he can't change, he can't get in a time machine, and 86% of American voters don't think anybody should be president over the age of 75. So that's where Republicans still have an advantage against Joe Biden.